Luton Town and QPR fifth round replay.
Well, psychologically, the balance of this tie has swung Luton's way, but Queen's Park Rangers are hoping to counteract that with the return of David Seaman. England's number three goalkeeper has missed 12 matches with a broken thumb. Seaman replaces Nicky Johns, and Jim Smith has to make one other change. Top scorer Gary Bannister damaged a knee on Saturday, so John Byrne, who scored the winner against Luton in a fourth round replay last year, is in from the start. No problems for Ray Harford, who has named this unchanged Luton side. In the Steen brothers and Mick Harford, it contains three genuine strikers, which was a problem for Queen's Park Rangers' defensive system in the first meeting. Indeed, Mick Harford, settled now with a new contract and an England cap, invariably scores against Rangers, as he did again on Saturday. A busy week for referee Alan Gunn, who last night took charge of Tottenham against Manchester United. And here at Kenilworth Road, space allocated for some 2,500 visiting fans. It's a night that makes you think more of the Winter Olympics than the Wembley finale in May of this competition. We've had some snow flurries, but a great prize at stake for the winners. A home six-round tie to Portsmouth. Both sides doing reasonably well in the first division this season, and the first meeting at Loftus Road, an indication that there isn't a great deal to choose between the two clubs. Warren Neal, who got the Rangers goal on Saturday, and David Seaman's first kick is certainly a little rusty, and Luton have the throw. Tim Breaker. Into the feet of Mark Steen, and then Brian Steen. Danny Wilson with the early cross. McDonald staying close to Harford, and Ashley Grimes looking for a spot of early glory, and playing for not only a place in a cup run, but for a place maybe with the Republic of Ireland and Jack Charlton's squad in the summer. Falco. Here's Faraday. Brock. It was an excellent crossroad for the ball. Falco, and I think he was trying to guide it down for Byrne rather than head for goal. He's a very unselfish player, Mark Falco. Jim Smith, the Queen's Park Rangers manager, said at the start of the season, a place in the top 10 at the end of the First Division campaign and a place at Wembley. That was the ambitions for the club. Well, they're looking good on the first count. Harford. McDonough did well. Wilson in support of Mark Steen. Breaker. Brian Steen. And Mark Steen, easily the best effort of the game so far. 27 minutes gone. And the first genuine strike in anger. And the Steen brothers' understanding was at the core of it. Brian down for Mark. Faraday keeps it in and keeps his footing. And then runs straight into Donaghy. Harford. Two strong men, Mick Harford and Alan McDonald. And McDonald penalised, the free kick quickly taken by Brian Steen. Furthest forward here is McDonough, Allinson, Mark Steen! Allinson got it back into the middle, and it came very quickly to Mark Steen. Donna laid it off. Allinson whipped it in, and it deflected, I think, to Steen, who just stuck out a foot, and it flew over the top when the crowd were baying for the first goal. Wilson. Steen won it back, in from Bryans. That's McDonough. When Rangers were protesting that Harford was pushing, Darren McDonough came round the back. Alan Gunn was having nothing to do with the pleas from Queen's Park Rangers. Harford there pushed down McDonald. McDonough got to the ball. Had it gone in, it would have counted. And then Martin Allen. Well, that was a snapshot, and it nearly caught out Seeley. The one thing about the artificial surface is the ball does sit nicely for those who want to shoot, and Martin Allen wasted no time, and that was close. 45 more minutes played in this tie, still nothing between the two sides. Park Rangers have come here with a strong competitive instinct and push Luton all the way. The best two efforts, certainly the two closest, from Mark Steen. A half volley that was well held by Seaman, and then a snap chance that flew over the top. Half time, it's Luton Town 0, Queen's Park Rangers 0. Luton Town last reached the sixth round 2 years ago, 3 years ago. Under David Pleat, they were losing semi-finalists, of course. But they're facing a team in Queen's Park Rangers who have never lost an FA Cup tie on a synthetic surface. Breaker. Maybe Luton will be looking a little more for from him. Down that right-hand side, and Grimes down the left. And Brian Steen, can he keep it in play? Yes. Faced by Neil. And Seaman had to be very quick then. With Mark Steen coming in for the kill around the near post area. Bird. Tried to reverse it to where Falco made his run. And just look at the way the ball raced away from Faraday. The winter showers this afternoon slicked up the top. Harford. Can Queen's Park Rangers sustain this performance? Harford. Mark Steen. Questioning looks from Falco and Byrne about the nature of the ball forward there. Pushing by Harford. Falco would have been in, but the chance was Burns, which he battled to create. And he had to take the chance quickly. Seeley dropped it and then hauled it in again before Falco could pounce. Kersley. Brock again, who doesn't deserve to be a loser, but it's looking more and more as though he will be. The defending has taken on a more panicky look over the last 10 minutes, but there's a breakout here with Allinson. Luton happy to have the ball down in this corner of the pitch. Parker. Now Dawes. Kersley for Coney. Alan Gunn has looked at his watch. Two teams so well matched. But it's looking as though the tie indeed has been decided by an own goal. Luton progressed into the quarter-finals of the FA Cup. They play Portsmouth here in the next round. Queen's Park Rangers have beaten them an artificial surface in an FA Cup tie for the first time. And they'll surely reflect that they lost their best chance on their own carpet on Saturday. Jim Smith reflects as he goes off.